Let me ask you something. Have you ever really thought about where your water comes from? We turn on the taps and like magic, it's there. Clean, fresh, life-giving water. But what if I told you that for billions of people, that magic is running out? And what if I told you the solution, a truly revolutionary one, might be hiding in a place we least expected? The crushing depths of our oceans. Hey everyone. Welcome back to PhysxX, and in this video we are going to talk about a California-based company that's flipping the script on desalination. They are pioneering a technology that takes the whole process deep underwater. We're talking 400 meters, that's over 1300 feet below sea level, and in a way solving our freshwater problem. We are facing a global water crisis. It's not some far-off dystopian future, it's happening right now. Here in southwestern United States, we are seeing droughts so severe that Lake Mead, a lifeline for 40 million people, looks like a shadow of its former self. Those stark white bathtub rings, they're a terrifying reminder of how much water we've lost in just a few decades. And this isn't just an American problem, it's a global story. The land our rivers flow through are the driest they have ever been over 1,000 years. Think about that, 1,200 years. History is littered with civilizations that crumbled, brought to their knees by a lack of water. The ancestral Puebloans of the American Southwest, the mighty Ming Dynasty in China, their stories are a stark warning. But here's the kicker. Those historical droughts, as devastating as they were, often lasted less than 20 years. We are in the year 25 of the current mega drought in the Southwest, and honestly, there is no end in sight. Climate change is rewriting the rules, making droughts more frequent, more severe, and more widespread. Every single year, an area the size of Vermont and New Hampshire combined succumb to drought. Yet our global population keeps growing. More and more of us are moving to cities, and all of us need water. So the big question is, what are we going to do about it? Now, we are not just sitting idly by. We have been trying to tackle this. Take California for example. The Carlsbad desalination plant is a massive facility that's stepping in where the Colorado River is falling short, turning salty ocean water into fresh drinking water for San Diego County. It's a pretty incredible feat of engineering, and it's a part of a growing global trend. Right now, there are about 21,000 desalination plants operating in around 150 countries. The Middle East and North Africa are huge on this. And most of these plants, over 3/4 of them, use a technology called reverse osmosis, or RO. Sounds straightforward, right? Reverse osmosis basically forces salt water against a super fine membrane. Think of it like a microscopic bouncer at a club. It lets the tiny water molecules through, but it blocks the larger salt particles along with microbes and other yucky stuff. Simple in concept, but it comes with some pretty hefty complications. First off, it takes a massive amount of energy. You're essentially brute forcing water through this membrane with powerful pumps, and that chews through electricity. About 3 kilowatt hours for every cubic meter of fresh water. To put that in perspective, back in 2016, the world's desalination plants used as much energy as the entire country of Chile. And with demand for fresh water skyrocketing, that energy use is expected to more than double by 2050. And with great power comes great emissions. Most of these RO plants run on fossil fuels. That means desalination is a major source of CO2, not to mention nitrogen and sulfur dioxide. In 2016 alone, these plants pumped out 76 million tons of CO2. That's like adding millions of extra cars on the road. And it's projected to get much worse. Then there is the brine. After you squeeze out the fresh water, you are left with this super salty, concentrated gunk. Disposing of it is a huge environmental headache. Often, it's just pumped back into the ocean, where it can harm marine ecosystems. Plus, many traditional plants use chemicals in the process, which can also end up back in the environment. So, while we're solving one problem, we're kind of creating others. It's a classic case of robbing Peter to pay Paul. Now, you might be thinking, why not just power them with renewables? And that's a great thought. There are some plants, like one in Saudi Arabia, that are using solar. But what happens when the sun goes down? They often switch back to power grid, which, you guessed it, is often fossil fuel based. So we need a solution that's not just effective but truly sustainable around the clock. But what if there were a better way? A way to get fresh water from the ocean without the massive energy bill and harmful byproducts? This is where things get really exciting. Enter OceanWell, a California-based company that's flipping the script on desalination. They're pioneering a technology that takes the whole process deep underwater. We're talking 400 meters, that's over 1300 feet below sea level. Why so deep? Because at those depths, the ocean itself provides the power. Remember that feeling when you dive to the bottom of a deep swimming pool? That pressure in your ears. Now multiply that by 100. That's the kind of immense natural hydrostatic pressure OceanWell is harnessing. Instead of using energy-guzzling pumps on land to push saltwater through membranes, OceanWell uses the ocean's own pressure to do the heavy lifting. It's genius. So how does this actually work? OceanWell has designed these incredible modular units called pods. Each one is about 13 meters or 40 feet tall. Think of a small underwater tower. Inside these pods are standard reverse osmosis membrane, the same kind used in land-based plants. But here's the clever part. The immense external water pressure at depths naturally forces seawater through these membranes. The system then just needs a little bit of energy, much less than traditional plants, to create a gentle suction on the freshwater side to keep it flowing and pump it to the shore. This method slashes energy requirements by up to 40% compared to even the most advanced land-based systems. That's a huge deal. And because they're using the ocean's natural pressure, they don't need to preheat the water with harsh chemicals. Plus, their life-safe circulation system is designed to prevent any harm to marine life. No scary intake pipes sucking in unsuspecting fish. And what about nasty brine? OceanWell's process is different. They're not trying to squeeze every last drop of fresh water out in one go, which is what land-based plants do to save energy. The leftover water isn't nearly as concentrated. It's only slightly saltier than surrounding deep-sea water. This mildly saline water is then gently dispersed through risers into deep ocean currents, where it diffuses rapidly and harmlessly. No toxic brine plumes, no ecological dead zones. It's a game changer for marine environments. Each of these pods can produce an incredible 1 million gallon. That's about 4,000 cubic meters of high-quality freshwater every single day. And because they're modular, OceanWell can create water farms by linking multiple pods together, scaling the system up or down to meet demand. Their first projected water farm is aiming to supply 220,000 cubic meters a day. That's 58 million gallons, enough for a whole lot of people. And the water quality, it's not just free from salt. OceanWell's system filters out bacteria, viruses, pesticides, and even those nasty PFAS chemicals we're hearing so much about. The result is ultra clean, healthy, high quality fresh water, pure and simple. Now, you might be wondering, is this stuff actually proven? Can it really work reliably down there in the dark, crushing depths? And that's a fair question. But here's the cool part. Offshore operations, especially in the subsea energy industry, have been refining this kind of deep-sea technology for decades. The major components OceanWell uses are already designed to withstand even deeper environments and handle tougher substances than water, under constant pressure for very long periods. They're also designed to integrate standard RO membranes, so they can always use the latest and the greatest in membrane tech. And laying subsea pipelines to bring that fresh water to shore, that's a well-practiced process. So who's going to use this? Well, OceanWell is already partnering with the Las Virgenes Municipal Water District, right here in Southern California, to build its first deep-sea water farm. Imagine the possibilities for other drought-stricken coastal cities around the world. Los Angeles, Cape Town, cities across the Mediterranean, island nations, the list goes on. And because the system is offshore, it frees up valuable coastal lands, which is a huge plus in crowded urban areas. There's even an added bonus. The fresh water produced by these deep sea ports is extremely cold. OceanWell is exploring ways to pass this cold water through cooling stations before it's delivered, harnessing the temperature difference to provide large-scale cooling for industrial or commercial use. That means even more energy savings. Okay, now I think it's the time to address the elephant in the room, or rather, the squid in the deep sea. Some of you might be thinking, this sounds too good to be true. What are the catches? Will it raise the cost of fresh water? What about maintenance? Why hasn't this been done before? These are all valid points. The idea of deep sea RO has actually been around since the 1960s. But back then, the thought of installing and powering pumps and electronics at such depths was just too far out, technologically speaking. But today, thanks to advancements in subsea engineering, driven largely by the offshore oil and gas industry, ironic, I know, companies have developed pumps and systems that are watertight at incredible depths and rarely need maintenance. Companies like Norway's Fofsea and its spin-off, Floshen, are also working on similar deep-sea desalination concepts, repurposing technology originally designed to extract fossil fuels to now substantially pull fresh water from the ocean. As for cost, while there is an initial investment in the subsea infrastructure, the significant energy saving over the lifespan of the project are expected to make it very competitive, if not cheaper, than traditional desalination, especially as energy prices rise. And maintenance. The ports are designed for easy servicing and component replacement, minimizing downtime. So what does all this mean for our future? OceanWell's technology and others like it hold the promise of a more sustainable, environmentally friendly way to secure fresh water for coastal communities. Michael Porter, OceanWell's CTO, even envisioned a future where these underwater RO farms are powered by nearby offshore wind turbines, further cutting costs and reducing their onshore footprints to almost nothing. Imagine that. A closed-loop system harnessing the power of the ocean and the wind to create life's most essential resource. Could this be the breakthrough that helps us finally get a handle on the global water crisis? It's not a silver bullet. We still need to focus on conservation, better water management, and protecting our existing freshwater resources. But for millions, perhaps billions of people living in water-stressed coastal regions, deep-sea desalination offers a very real, very hopeful path forward. We started by asking if the solution to our water crisis could be hiding in the deep ocean. It seems like the answer is a resounding yes. As we face a future with increasingly severe droughts and growing demand for water, innovations like OceanWells aren't just clever engineering, they might just be our lifeline. The question is, are we ready to deep dive for these solutions? What do you think? Could this be the future of fresh water? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. And as always, please subscribe and thanks for watching.